Hi, I'm Mark Farber, and this is Accounting Fundamentals. In our last two videos, we created the income statement, the balance sheet, and the statement of owner's equity for the company represented by this adjusted trial balance. And we saw how we went through and prepared the financial statements, and we said at the end of the last video that we're not quite done yet. And the reason is this. Think about what some of these accounts are. Now, up here we have cash, accounts receivable. Let's look at cash, for instance. If on December 31st you went to bed, having just had a nice party for the new year, and you had $4,000 in your account, and then you woke up on January 1st, you'd expect there would still be $4,000 in your account. In other words, this is a permanent account. Any asset account is a permanent account. Whatever you owned on December 31st, you still own on January 1st. Same goes for loans. If you owed the bank on December 31st, $3,000, come January 1st, you still owe them $3,000. It doesn't mysteriously just disappear. However, revenue, well, that's how much you earned last year. So as of December 31st, you'd earned $20,000 of revenue. But on January 1st for the new year, your revenue is zero. You haven't earned any yet. You haven't incurred any expenses yet because the year has just begun. And so we need to zero these accounts out. And as we've seen, the way that we zero out an account or the way that we change the value in any account is by doing journal entries and then posting them to the ledger accounts. So let's do that. First of all, as I said, we have to recognize that these accounts here and these here are permanent accounts, okay? In other words, assets and liabilities are permanent accounts. We don't have to close those out. They just keep going forever and ever and ever. But these accounts here and this are temporary accounts. So withdrawals and our income statement accounts, we only track how much is in those accounts for a particular time period, month, year, whatever, and then we have to zero them out. So let's go through the process of doing that. What I'll do first is I'll just set up T accounts for each of these. So I have revenue, salary expense, and I'll just use some abbreviations here. Rent expense. Normally we would already have the T accounts in order to produce the adjusted trial balance, but we can go backwards just as easily. And then over here I have $20,000, salary was 10, this was 6,000, and 1,000. Okay. Well, what we do want, oh, and we need, of course, withdrawals. And withdrawals had $1,000. What we want is to zero these out. And the way that we zero them out is we basically have to, in this case, since there's a $20,000 credit balance, we have to put a $20,000 debit into it. So the first step that we're going to do in closing our accounts is we're going to close revenue. So step one is close revenue, and I won't write them down because, again, I'm short on space. But to close revenue, what I'm going to do is I'm going to debit revenue, in this case, $20,000. And I need to credit something. So I'm going to make up an account called Income Summary. I didn't make it up. It actually exists for this purpose. And we're going to credit Income Summary $20,000. So when we debit revenue $20,000, it magically goes to zero. And here's my income summary account. And we credited it $20,000. That was step one in closing the accounts. Step two is we have to close all of the expense accounts. So again, I've got debit balances in all of them, so I need to credit each of these accounts by the same amount in order to get a zero balance. So let's leave the debit blank for the moment and we'll go through and we'll credit each one of these accounts. So we'll credit salary expense, 10,000, and rent expense, and that was 6,000. And finally, other expense. $1,000. And I'm going to debit, again, I got to put those somewhere. I'm going to debit income summary. You'll see why it's called income summary in a minute. And I'm going to debit it, the balance of this, which is $16,000, $17,000. So if I post all of these now, I'm going to debit income summary, $17,000. Credit salary expense, 10,000. Credit this 6,000, and credit this 1,000. And now that goes to zero. Notice that I'm putting the zero, even though it's a zero balance, you could really write it on either side, and you can put a dash if you want instead of a zero. Notice I'm putting it on the side that we normally have a balance in that account. In other words, revenue is a credit account, so it goes on the credit side. These expense accounts are debit accounts, and so put the zero on the debit side. You don't have to do that, but that's, again, sort of an accounting convention. So that's step two. I've closed out all of my expense accounts. They're all ready to go. Okay. Now I've got this account income summary. Well, what am I going to do with that? Well, I may as well figure out what the balance is. 20,000 minus 17,000 is 3,000. And remember, we put it on the side of the larger number, so we're going to put it here. So it has a credit of 3,000. Now, if you remember back to the last video, we said that the net profit for this company was $3,000. After all, $20,000 was the revenue, $17,000 was the total expenses, so the difference is the profit. So that's why we call this the income summary. It's another way of, or our check, if you will, to make sure we're doing this all right, is to compare this number with the net profit number on the income statement we just did. And they match, so that's good. So we're left with our income summary. Now what we have to do is step three. We have to close this account out to our capital account, to our owner's equity. Remember, owner's equity is equal to investments plus revenue minus expenses, minus withdrawals. So we've already, when we calculated our owner's equity, we added in investments when we were doing our statement of owner's equity. Now we've got to move this $3,000 into our capital account. So I'm just going to slide that in over here. Here's our capital. And it has a balance of $8,000, credit balance. So step three in closing my accounts is I'm going to reduce this to zero. It has a $3,000 credit balance, so I need to debit it. So I'm going to debit income summary, $3,000. And I'm going to credit, move that into capital. So debit income summary, $3,000. It goes to zero, and I move that, I credit capital, 3,000. I know it's getting a little busy here. Bear with me, one more step. The last thing, so we've zeroed out revenue and all of our expense accounts, or we've closed those accounts. Now we just have to close out the other temporary account, withdrawals. Well, it has a debit balance, so we need to credit it, $1,000. So you've probably already figured out where that's going. Withdrawals reduces our capital, so I debit capital. We don't have to go through income summary here because it's not an income account. Debit capital, 1,000, and I credit withdrawals, 1,000. When I credit withdrawals, they're zeroed out. I'm ready to go for the next period. And I debited capital. And now if I want to calculate my total capital, it's 8 plus 3 is 11,000 minus 1 is 10,000. So I have a credit balance of $10,000 in my capital account. And if you go back to the statement of owner's equity, same 10,000 that you'll see there. Okay, so we basically just reflected in the ledger accounts what we already put onto our income statement and our balance sheets and other financial statements. Okay, so we've closed out all the accounts. There's one last step that has to be done. All of these journal entries have been made. They've all been posted into the appropriate accounts. Whenever we post into accounts, we have to do a trial balance to make sure that everything still balances. Well, none of our permanent accounts would have been affected by that. And all of these accounts from this line down will all have gone to zero. Withdrawals is now zero, revenue is zero, and all of our expenses are zero. So all of this just falls off. I'm not going to redraw it. What we're left with is these accounts are unchanged, and the only difference is this 8,000 is now 10,000. And if you look at it carefully, you'll see $10,000 of capital plus 3 plus 2 is 15,000 of credits. 11 plus 4 is $15,000 of debits. So our closing trial balance is in balance. And it should have zeros for all of these things. And in fact, we normally don't even record any of the accounts that have zero balances. We only show the accounts that have balances. So our closing trial balance reflects the fact that we've made all of these adjustments. These things are all zero now. And now we're ready to start recording transactions for the new year. And we go through the exact same process of recording our transactions in the journal, posting them to the ledger, creating our trial balance, doing our adjusting entries, creating an adjusted trial balance, creating financial statements, close them out again, and over and over and over. And that's the accounting process.